We're looking at Palm Sunday, and you heard the gospel early on, right at the beginning of the service, and you know what this is about if you've come to church for years on Holy Week or this day, about Jesus coming into Jerusalem for the last time. You've got to realize he's coming in, and he's not going to come out alive. So he's going in for the final week of his life. And as he's traveling, I just imagine in my mind, because I don't know if it's possible or not, but when he's coming down the Mount of Olives and down a road, down to the city gates of Jerusalem, it's where Jesus died, was across the city and outside the gates. I'm not sure you can see it, but if not, it's just across. And that's where he was put to death. And do you know that donkeys have an X or a cross on their backs or someplace? Do you know that? Most donkeys do. So he's riding very lowly and he's on a donkey, thinking about the cross, and there's the cross awaits him, and he's heading for the cross as he's going down the hill to the main gates on that side of Jerusalem. I want to talk about the Word of God today because that's what it's really about things that carry Jesus into the midst of people who need Jesus. Jerusalem needed Jesus. Everybody needs Jesus, but he came in order to die so that he could reach all people, and all people could receive the forgiveness of sins through repentance and faith in Jesus Christ. And so why God's word? Because today, what's the donkey? What's the donkey today that carries and transports Jesus? Remember we had all those problems with transportation of, you know, people buying goods and you couldn't get things to your house? You all suffered from that, right? You didn't get something delivered on time. There were not enough delivery drivers. It was just chaotic. We're talking about transportation problems here. And there's going to be some problems, and we'll get to that when we talk about ourselves. Because ourselves, we are also, aren't we? Carriers of Jesus. But the donkey transports Jesus. Jesus always uses other instruments and he uses people to evangelize or share Christ. And so he's coming into the midst, and before he does, he says, I have a need of a donkey. He's not going to go into Jerusalem until he has a donkey. He's going to be carried into Jerusalem, which is how he operates. Even today, again, it's the Word of God he uses. It is through the Word of God that Jesus Christ is transported to us, brought to people, introduced. He is introduced to people through that. Some of the scriptures about the Word of God. Remember in the beginning, Genesis 1, God said, let there be light, and there was light. God's Word is powerful. It's a powerful thing. It accomplished powerful things. And then in John 1:11, John plays with this first verse of the whole Bible, and says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, the Word was light. So Jesus is the Word, first of all. But we need to transport him. He waits for us. He's waiting for the disciples. Would you go get the donkey? I'm waiting for you. You know, untie it. He gave instructions. He's not going anywhere until he gets some help. And unfortunately, that's how God works today. Why unfortunately? Because we don't act as good transportation elements in his enterprise, because we're not sharing Christ, are we? We're not making Christ known in such a way that we see dozens of men and women come to faith in Jesus Christ. So why did he include somebody else? I don't know, but he always does it. That's how he does it, and we need to catch up into what he's calling us to do. Isaiah 55, the rain and snow come down from heaven in the same way my word, God says, comes out of my mouth, and it returns not empty, but accomplishes what I desire to do. God's word is powerful. It creates, but it also is going to create faith. That John 1 passage, the word, it's all about faith in the Gospel of John. He creates faith. Then you have Paul preaching, and he says, one of those listening, the Bible says, was Lydia. The Lord opened her heart to respond to Paul's message. Lydia needed to hear the message. Now, we've been talking a lot about soft evangelism, and that's the way we're going to go. We hopefully all of you have your 3 to 5, 6, 7, 8 names of people in your world, your orbit, who don't know Christ yet, and you're going to pray regularly. You're going to get your life in order morally and looking more and more like Christ. As we do that, we're going to be attractive. People are going to want what we have. People are going to want what's in us. And so Lydia, it's the Word of God that was needed for the Holy Spirit to move and open her heart. Acts chapter 2, when they heard Peter preaching the Word. Because, by the way, the word is finally going to be preached, isn't it? Now, it may not be by you. You may not never see yourself as that. But if you're praying for the people in your orbit, if you're trying to make your life aligned to Christ more, that's great. But at some point, somebody's going to have to hear the Word of God. That's the one that carries and bears Jesus to the world, is the Word. And unfortunately, again, we're involved with that. He's perfect. He's waiting. The Holy Spirit's always waiting. I want to bring people to faith in Christ, and it's us who have excuses. Well, think of the excuses, many excuses we have. And there's two things that the Word does. It brings Christ into a believer's life deeper, more deeper, right? I mean, we deepen our life with God through the Word of God. That's what carries Christ. As we talk about the Word of God, center on the Word of God, our faith grows. Christ comes into us and in us more than he did before. But also for those not saved, they need to hear the Word. Eventually, they're going to have to hear the Word. Now, he tells two disciples to go and untie the colt. And if there's a problem, just tell them, I have a Visa card. That's not true. They didn't have Visa cards back then. I don't know if you knew that. Go untie it. So they went and they untied it, but then there was opposition. What are you untying the colt for? I mean, these people knew the owner. They weren't going to let him get by with anything, but they kind of talked to him about Jesus needing it, which is weird. Jesus needed it. Jesus needed a donkey. Jesus needs us. Same thing. You got to make that correlation, that jump. But they overcame the obstacles and got the donkey, right? But there's excuses. There's always obstacles, isn't there? How about growing spiritually? When we gather on the Word of God, hear the Word of God, speak the Word of God, meditate on the Word of God, the Spirit of Jesus Christ in us, he comes more powerfully. He speaks more powerfully. We hear him. We're brought into a deeper Christ-likeness. And so we have these obstacles. Also for growing in faith, we have obstacles, right? We need the Word of God as Christians to continue to deepen that. All kinds of obstacles, isn't there? Well, I'm not enough time. Too busy. I don't really like to do that so much. I mean, there's a million excuses. But we've been emphasizing evangelism here. We're going to keep doing that. We want to get to where we can make a difference. We want, because of our involvement in life, we want many, many women, men and women in the coming years to know Jesus Christ through our witness, through our lives. And again, we're talking about you don't have to go to McDonald's. You become Christ-like. You love unconditionally. You pray regularly for the people in your orbit. You will get chances to represent Jesus Christ, so that men and women may know Jesus. And so the Word of God is the donkey that holds the Christ. Martin Luther talked about the manger. He didn't say it was the donkey, but it really is, right? The manger is the donkey that holds Christ up. So the shepherd's psalm, the wise man's psalm. So that's also a vehicle. And, of course, the Word of God holds up Christ. Martin Luther said that the Word of God is like the manger. But there's also something else besides the Word of God. We transport Jesus. And that's probably the most effective thing. With the Word. See, Jesus is waiting. Because there's a team effort, apparently. I don't know if they didn't see the memo or what, but he said, this is a team effort, guys. I'm not going until you get me what I need. I need to be transported into Jerusalem. The disciples provided it, and he was brought into Jerusalem. And we're just assuming that through his time that last week that many people came to believe in him. And so we are the donkeys. It's better than monkeys, I suppose. But it's still pretty, it seems pretty low, right? And yet he used it. He wants to use us. He desperately wants to use us. The problem is we tie up the Word of God. It's tied up. We get tongue-tied. It's tied up because of our lack of commitment to the Word. Or we don't know it. Whole denominations now are starting to less and less believe in the authority of Scripture. There's all kinds of obstacles here coming. But it needs to be untied because it's been tied up because of our embarrassment of Christ, because of our concern about not knowing what to say. There's lots of excuses, and I'm with you on those. I'm not preaching to you something that I don't also struggle with. But we are the donkey. He needs to use us. He's chosen to need to use us. And he said, you are in charge of the donkey. You're in charge of the Word of God. Church, you're in charge of the Word of God. Jesus made us an administrator of the Word of God. We administrate it. If we don't administrate it and make it known and get it out, nobody will. There's nobody on earth that's going to do that, except for individual believers and the church as a whole. And so God says to us, he reminds us to untie the Word of God. If the Word of God is untied in our lives, it's going to make a difference in everything. That's why, you know, our grow in faith, impact the world. Grow in faith, impact the world. We can grow in faith only if we distribute the Word of God in our own lives. You know, trying to form some devotional element where the Word of God is regularly in your life. I encourage you, my wife does have access. We have the Bible on our phones. She put that on. I wouldn't know how to start, but it's free. And then there's also an app for music. Like I know an app for contemporary music, and Kay can help you find those. But we really want in this church, we want to grow. If we're going to grow, we need the Word of God. We got to untie the Word of God. We got to get people into small groups, into personal devotions. And I'm assuming you're with me on that. We have to untie, though. We've just got to remove these obstacles that keep us in a faith that's kind of uneventful, ineffective. Right? Isn't that right? I mean, if it wasn't ineffective, wouldn't we see more people come to faith in Jesus? Now, I do believe people come to Christ. If they come to a church and not in Christ, or they keep hearing the gospel message, you know, who knows who those people are. But I don't think there are a ton of them. We have to untie. We have to loose the Word of God. Somebody's going to have to speak a word at some point. And for us, we need to include and involve the Word of God more in our life, because we're the donkey. I'm sorry. We're the donkey. And Jesus needs us to bring him to people. Well, when Jesus sent out a bunch of the disciples, not just the 12, but a bunch of the disciples one time, he sent them out to the towns where he was going to go. He sends us out and into the lives of people to whom Jesus will come after they hear the Word of God. We need to untie the Word of God. We need to make it more prominent in our lives. We need to seek to revolve our life around it, because it's central and it's key to us representing Christ and being that donkey in the world, both to ourselves through spiritual growth and to others. I want to offer prayer now for that to happen, for us to be quickened. I remember when I gave my life to Christ, I was so thirsty for the Word of God, I just read voraciously. But sometimes there's periods that I don't read voraciously. That's okay. You don't have to beat yourself up. But we need the Word if we're going to move forward in faith and in making a difference in the world with others who don't have it. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for your Word. Thank you that you have provided Jesus Christ in this world, held by the manger. We thank you also that you have made the Word of God prominent. I mean, there's Bibles everywhere. Thank you for that. Thank you for the freedom to discuss, preach on, and pray the Scriptures now today and every Sunday. We pray, Lord God, that you would help us to bring the Word of God into our life more. Help us, Lord, to have a greater thirst for you and for your Word. And help us, Father, be better representatives of you. May we be donkeys that bring you into the lives of people who need to know you. In Jesus' name, amen.